Welcome back to the workshop. On the build in front of you here, we're going to be doing the Chris at Classic Plastic 101 tribute build. Chris is a great guy. He got me back into model building. I had looked around YouTube for some fun model channels. I hadn't built a plastic model in many years, and I came across his channel, Classic Plastic 101. He likes to educate. He doesn't preach. He doesn't have any drama on his channel, and he's just an all-around real nice guy. So Chris and I have talked before on Facebook. We've had conversations about what we like. Him and I both like sailing ships. We like anything older like that. He's also a great car builder, but for a build, a tribute to him from me, it's going to be to put together Ravel's Germany's excellent Viking ship. I've done a full kit review of this prior on my channel. You can go ahead and look that up. I'll try to get a description or a link in the description for you. Otherwise, right now, I'm just going to start building it. We really don't have to go through a lot of the parts. We'll just do a quick overview of everything that's going to be in here. We've got two hull pieces, hull halves, which go together quite nicely. They're about 15 inches long. And we've got some great wood grain on there. Then we've got a deck. We've got oars, lots of oars. And we've got a massive amount of shields that have to have decals or decals applied for you folks over in Europe. Then we've got a blow molded sail. I'm trying to pick up over here. I've got to cut that out, weather that up a little bit. So I'm going to get right to painting and building. The Viking ship from Ravel, Germany is going to be my next build. We'll see you at the next steps. Chugging right along on the Viking ship build. I've got the hull together. Big sexy there. No seams to worry about. No nothing. Just had to clamp the mastheads on the end and let them hold for a little bit. The next step after, of course, everything's been washed already. The mast is together. I don't want to go any further till I get my base colors on. You can see there's a huge amount of shields. We've got a lot of oars. I'm going to be base coating them as well, primering them, whatever you want to call it. First coat of paint on there. And the deck. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to prime the hull with a flat black primer. I'm going to prime the deck and everything else with a tan colored primer. So I can start working on them and creating them into looking like real wood. Now, the colors I'm going to try out this time, I've never used these before, are Rust-Oleum colors. It's a khaki. In their camouflage paint, the only reason I picked it was because it was dirt cheap, like $3 a can on sale, and they're black. Now, to me, they seem, when I just shot a test spray over on the painting area, seem like they were just primers, is what it seems like to me. They're just selling it under a different name, calling it camo. They have an olive drab as well that I did purchase. I'll be using that on some military kits as a base coat as well. But I think they're just primers, so we're going to shoot them on the plastic. It should dry nice and quick. I'll hit him with the heat gun as usual. Then I have to start working on making everything look like wood. And then I have a gajillion decals to put on these shields. That's going to be a long day right there. So I'll get that primer coat on and then we'll be back when I continue with assembly and painting. The next step in my process after getting the primer on, you can see that the primer worked real nice. Got a nice black coat on there, that camouflage paint. I'm almost positive is just a flat primer. I've got the tan on the shields. Now, the shields are a big job. What I'm going to do is, on the decal sheet, and I'll show you over here, you can see that the centers have these silver look to them. Well, placing a decal on something this size with that small of a detent is just going to be, it's going to be problematic. I don't want to go through 3 gallons of decal softener getting them to settle down on that nib. So what I'm doing is, I've come up with a plan. I'm taking a silver paint pencil and coloring the center sections. And you can see it goes nice and quick. And it looks like old metal, old steel when they put it together. So that turns out just fine. And I've got a gajillion of those to go. What I'm going to do then is, of course, another step will be to wash the backs of these, make them look like real wood. It's just going to need a dark wash in there and a little bit of craft paint. Going back to the front, once that's all done and dried, I'll finish doing all my silver circles with just a nice little silver pencil from Hobby Lobby. Then, what I figured out is that each one of these center pieces is 1/8 of an inch. Exactly 1/8. Each one of these, thankfully, is the exact same size. Sometimes those sizes won't line up. But each little metal part of the shield there, center, is 1/8 of an inch. So I grabbed my hole punch. These are just from Harbor Freight, a couple bucks after a coupon, and grabbed the 1/8 inch hole punch. And all I have to do, as the decals are ready to go, is just punch out the center section, and they're ready to apply. And you can see, when we get the decal on there, we'll get it lined up. That fits around there perfectly. You can see the little nib sticks through. The decal will settle down. The outside of the decal is silver. That'll give us our metallic look to the outside of the shield, and it's going to make my life way easier. Still going to take a long time, but applying all those decals won't be, you know, applying the decal, covering it with Microsol, Microset, waiting 2 days for everything to shrink down and all that. I should be able to cut off 2 shields at a time, soak them, apply them, soak them, apply them, soak them, apply them, and work my way till I'm all the way done. Then cut them free, prepare them for the ship. After that, I've got to start painting this in a wood tone. Same with the deck, same with everything else. Get it all wood tone, then do the gluing. Then I've got to figure out how to stain the blow molded sail. All right, I'm not sure how well paint's going to adhere to that. I already did a spray paint test on it, and it didn't melt with the primer I've been using, so maybe I'll find a way to use some of that to help me do it quickly. Rinse it out. I really don't think I'm going to be using the huge Viking center decal on that sail like they show on the box. I just don't like it. Other than that, I can continue working on this, and I'll come back as I make progress. See you in a little bit. Hello again. What's only been a couple seconds as the screen changed over for you has been a couple hours for me at least. I've got the hull assembled like I showed. You can see the deck is in there. The deck's been primed and painted with a nice honey brown over that tan khaki colored primer. Now that has to be heavily washed and weathered, but that's in place. This kit fits together so nice. That's not glued in. I can pop that out at any time to mess with it. I've got the hull painted in the color that I desire. The color that I used for the exterior hull is a craft paint called Milk Chocolate. That was brushed all over the black primered hull. Now, of course, that requires a lot of washing as well. You're going to notice that none of the paint is even. It's not evenly applied. Wood never looks even all the way through, especially one that's going to be shoved up onto rock beaches and stuff for pillaging. You can see the back of the shields are done. I've got those washed and weathered. And, ta-da, after about an hour's worth of work, letting them dry. It took about an hour to get them all on there. Let them dry, shot them with some dull coat to seal them in there. The shields are ready. They look super nice. There are a few decals that I made mistakes. There's nothing wrong with the decals. I made a couple mistakes on a couple of these and tore some of the decals. That'll be easy enough to hide, though. I'll just have them put behind another shield when they overlap each other. But the decals worked really, really well. They went on real smooth. You just left them in the water till they went completely flat, and then they slid right off. Punching that hole and pre-coloring the silver on the center of the shields worked out quite well. On the back, just a couple of the decals overlap a little too big. That'll be easy enough to fix in the next coming steps. Now we've got the shields done. We've got the hull. I can start weathering the hull. I've got the mast painted over the black. I did that in just a real quick brush up and down with the milk chocolate colored to leave it even darker than the hull itself, because it's got rigging and stuff sliding up and down it all the time, greased up with the animal fat, so it's going to get darker and darker, sort of like a plain wood handrail. Now the sail, I didn't know what I was going to do. I don't work with blow molded sails a lot. Most of the ships I have are the older antique style, and they have the hard plastic sails, but this is what I got, and this is what I like. This is a filthy sail. There's no way on the face of this planet that Vikings had bright white cotton sails. You couldn't grow cotton where they were. And when they were pillaging, they would just steal fabric. They wouldn't, you know, steal. So I'm guessing they had to make it like out of wool or some other kind of fabric or animal skins. So I really mussied up the blow molded plastic with some barnwood folk art paint, let it dry. Then I took a burnt sienna pencil and I loosely went in and highlighted the seams, kind of like they do on the box top. And that's what I ended up with, and I actually do kind of like it. It's going to be on there. It's going to look like a dirty, beat-up sail that they've taken up and down dozens of times, rolled up, stuffed in the front of the hull. It's gotten filthy. It's gotten blood and dirt and grime on it. That's what you end up with. So that's what I'm going to do for a blow-molded sail. That was pretty easy. Dry it with a heat gun. I don't need to seal it or anything because I'm not applying decals, and I'm not going to weather it anymore past this. I wanted a little bit of light white, brown, red in the seams there where they stitched it together with, you know, animal leather thongs like that to get it all to go together. That's my interpretation. That's my story. I'm sticking to it, and I like it quite a bit. It's going to blend in nicely. So I'm going to continue working. What I've got to do is start weathering up the hull, the deck, get those shields all cut free, get those glued on, and paint and weather the oars and whatnot, and we can start assembly, and then it's on to rigging from there. The mastheads on the front and back I have left black so far. I want to do those in a brushed, like a brass or a bronze. And I've got some rub and buff that I can use on those to make it look like a weathered bronze and buff color. I'm going to keep working. We'll be back. Hello again. Continuing work on the Viking ship for the tribute build. What I'm doing now is I've got it all weathered up. You see that there? Looks real sharp. Looks just like real wood. We'll get a better view of that when it's not in a white cloth where it stands out better. But you can see how the deck was weathered and beat up. And then I made channels using a Q-tip as I weathered it down both sides and the front and whatnot where the men would be standing and working. And then, of course, the rear deck I did in a little bit of a darker color. Collects a little more dirt back there or whatnot. So I'm just starting to put in some ropes and some lines where they would be from the mast. This isn't a really complicated rigging. And I've glued the upper mast to the sail. And that'll have to be strung up to the main mast too. It's just a one mast ship. So I've got some very small detail parts to put in. The oar holders and stuff like that. I've got to attach the rudder to the side. Once all the rigging and the sail is on, then I've got to get out about 3 gallons of super glue and attach on all these little pegs here. Attach all those shields and then insert all the oars. So I will continue working. When we come back, we should be close to done, if not already done. See you in a little bit. Well, you can check it out. The ship itself is done as far as I'm going with it. We got the sail mounted. We've got the anchor and the anchor rope. We've got some poles up here that are used to guide the sails according to the directions. Now what I need to start doing is mounting on all the little tiny shields, starting from the back and working my way to the front so that they stack underneath each other and still touch their pins. And then when I'm all done with that, and those are all glued into place, which will be used with the super glue, then I will have to push all the oars in place. And we'll consider this build done, except that I'll need to do the stand and the little nameplate, but that won't take long. I'll wait till the ship itself is all done. Then I'll putz around. We've got the rudder on. We've got my rigging all on the way I wanted it. We'll get a better look at that later. I'll put a dark background behind it. I'm going to keep working, 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 working. I got a lot of shields to glue on. And we'll come back when I'm all done with the Viking ship by Revell Germany. Welcome back. We're here for the final of Revell's Germany's gorgeous Viking ship build for the man, Chris, over at Classic Plastic 101. My tribute build to Mr. Cortell. As you can see, it's all done. It's all weathered up. I didn't put all the oars out. I didn't like all of them out. It looked really busy, and it also looked like a Roman galleon. Plus, the sail is up, so they'd be under sail. So, at the most, I just wanted to display a few oars so you could see how they would be hanging out of the ship all the time. That's how I wanted to display it. The rest, I kind of made a cool little display inside. You can see some lashed up here. You can see a bunch that they just stacked up to dry off on the rack there. And then you can see some that are lashed up and drying off up there. All the sails are on. That is a lot of point and glue, point and glue, point and glue. I'm positive eventually that I'm going to lose a couple of them. They'll just fall off and I'll have to reattach them. The deck, I think, looks great. Looks like real wood. I tried my best to get that a little weathered up and beat that up a little bit. So I wanted to stop it right there and let you see how that nice wash goes in there. I also did more rigging than they ask you to do in the manual. I just wanted to add some extra lines, and I thought it'd be more fun. So I've got lines on all 4 points of the sail like they request. The line that lowers the sail up here is the thicker line provided by Revell. And that was the only line provided by Revell that I used. They had the other line on that red plastic spool, and it's all crisscrossed on there, and it stayed permanently kinked. So I used some of my own thread that I use on other ships. And I rigged it all up and wired it all up. Made 3 guy wires in the back, 2 in the front for the main mast. Then, I ran this longer piece here, whoop, and intertwined it with the shorter piece down to one of the hooks so that it would be as if they wanted to raise and lower the sail on the main mast. They could do so with those ropes. We'll put it back on spin so you can take some more looks at it. You can pause this at any time, of course. Everything turned out real nice. I love those shields going all the way back. That's just so cool looking. They turned out wonderfully. You got to make sure you stack them in that pattern, one over the other, or they're never going to go on right. So they're stacked nicely. And then we've got the interior detailed. You can see more of that. We've got the anchor in. I did coil up some extra rope that I had from other ships for the anchor and put on some little eyelets so that they could attach it and shove it off the side. The sail, as you can see, turned out nice. No issues with that. And then, of course, all the threading on the sail. Let's get in there just a little bit. I did all that by hand. As usual with a model ship, you want to do all that by hand. And we'll bring you right back down. Now, the hull itself, that one spool of oars in there isn't secured. It's just laying in there because gravity works. But I'll tilt it up. You can see the detail on the hull and how nice that looks. That looks like real wood in there. And if I heard something click right, I probably lost another shield. I hardly used any glue at all. So yeah, I did. See, little guy fell off, but that's my fault, not the way they attach. I just didn't use much CA glue to start with because I wasn't sure how much I would need. But I can go in and reattach them. That won't be a problem. I can see the other one that just fell off, just came from the other side. But other than that, that's going to happen with something real small when you only use a little microscopic piece of glue. As far as I'm concerned, that's done. Chris, I hope you like it. Hope you enjoyed the build video. I'll see you at the next review.